off the back of the coach, trying to introduce the leadership group who are going to be giving their absolute utmost to get victories week in and week out. Please make them welcome in no particular order. We've got the likes of Nathan Fife, Andrew Brayshaw, Reece Tonka, David Mundy, Michael Walters, Alex Pierce. Here they come. Your leadership group for 2021. As we look at these fine footballers ready to go about their business, we'll start. And already we've got some involvement from down the front. Thank you, ladies. The captain. Welcome, Nathan. You've already put your hand up for, I think, mark and goal of the year during the pre-season. Things are going along beautifully. How do you feel before season 2021 with the excitement that's been generated by the fans and this expectation that this team's really on the build?
Yeah, thanks, Skeet, and thanks everyone for coming along tonight. Awesome to see such a good turnout. It's been a really quick ramp with the pre-season, and I, along with the other players, feel confident that we've got the work in. It's been different in that we started after Christmas, so it's been super compressed, but for my game, I feel like I'm in as good a condition to play the best footy of my career.
Yep, that's a great sign. 50 years, captain, by the way. Are you just like a normal job for you now? There's things you learn from year to year, but feeling comfortable in the role, and particularly with the leaders that you have on this stage tonight.
Yeah, it's my fifth year. You're always learning as a leader, and it's awesome to have Andy Brayshaw join us in the leadership group this year. Round of applause for Andy. Our leadership group is voted by the players, so the players choose who they want leading the club, which is a great and transparent system, and really allows a group of guys that represents the beliefs of all the playing groups. So I think we've got a great cross-section here.
That being said, it's a nice segue to Andrew. You must look to your right and to your left and think, this is esteemed company. Nice to be rewarded and recognised as one of the players that is given the task of leading from the front.
Yeah, pretty honoured to be voted in. As Nat said, it's voted by the players and coaches, so obviously they're sort of backing me in. And I think, yeah, a lot of the younger guys really think that I represent them well in the group and give them a bit of a voice as well. So in good company, all of these guys are elite leaders and elite people, so I'm really stoked to be a part of it.
Focus will still be on your game, and you took it to another level last year. It's always the task, isn't it? And Nathan knows as well as anyone, just the expectations keep rising the better you perform. What are your hopes for this year to try and maintain or even go up a cog or two?
Yeah, every year I'm looking to build on my game. Obviously last year was a nice step forward, and I'm looking to do the same thing again. There's plenty of aspects of my game that need improving, and I've been working on that hard this pre-season, and yeah, hopefully can get a bit more attacking and a bit more aggressive through the middle. So there's plenty of bits and pieces that I'm learning off these guys here, and plenty of coaches back at the club, so hopefully moving forward, yeah, I can take another big step forward.
David Mundy, I reckon I've done five or six of these pre-season launches, and every time they mention how many pre-seasons you're up to, it's now 18, which, just thinking about it, it doesn't bear thinking about. I assume they get harder, or do you get more leverage given your seniority?
Yeah, they increase one each year, so it's been a little while, but as Nate said, it's been a bit compressed this year, a little bit different. As I've gained experience within the club, some things change, but with the compressed pre-season this year, feels like I've done most of the work and very similar. I feel ready to go. Can't wait for next week.
And given the draft that the club's just had and the young players coming through, apart from feeling a little bit older when you drive in and see their driver's licence, tell us about the excitement they generate inside the squad.
Obviously the core group of our playing list is that 18 to 23-year-old group, which will take our football club through the journey for the next 10 to 15 years, hopefully. And I feel really privileged to still be a part of that and to be playing my part and helping both perform on field, but showing a bit of guidance and leadership off field. I hope that I'm imparting a little bit of knowledge and a bit of wisdom. I was described as wise when I got voted into this group this year, so that was really nice. But it's a really exciting time to be a part of the club. I feel like we've got a group that is more self-driven to succeed and get the most out of themselves than any group I've been a part of. So I can't wait for the season to roll around.
In a nutshell, where do you think you'll play most of your footy this year? No smart other comments similar from the crowd, thank you. Sir, can you please stand down? In fact, security.
Likely very similar to last year, mid-forward. Yeah.
Thank you, David, for that answer. Now, Sonny, looked at you forlornly coming off last Sunday. You'd all the hard yards during pre-season, and then you hear the ping.
Yeah, no, it wasn't good. Obviously, as you said, all the hard work we put in over the pre-season to go out there and hurt myself was unfortunate and annoying, but you know, I'm going to do everything I can to get back there as soon as I can, and I can't wait to put on the purple again.
That being said, Justin wants more goals this year, and every coach wants that. But Fremantle, I think it's fair to say, if you can improve that area of your game, we know defensively really sound, the midfield group's emerging, it's doable given the group you've got, and you're obviously one of the key components of that.
Yeah, definitely. I think you know, with the lineup and the structure we do have, especially with the young boys coming through, you know, you see guys like Lockie Schultz, you know, little Joel Weston we drafted, Liam Henry can kick goals as well. So there's no doubt that with the right help and the right support for those boys, they're going to come out and kick multiple goals for us as well.
And in brief, we talked with Justin about no crowds last year. You seem to be one of those blokes that thrives on, particularly at Optus, getting the fans involved and a bit of theatre with that. How much will that mean to hopefully get back to almost 100% at some stage this year?
Yeah, it means unreal. I mean, obviously, you know, us small forwards, we thrive off that type of stuff, the crowd getting behind us and screaming and shouting, and even the opposition crowd as well. It's always good to kick a goal against West Coast and stuff like that. So, you know, I thrive off that, and there's no doubt a lot of the younger boys coming through are going to thrive off it and, you know, and really enjoy it. I mean, you know, everyone wants footy back. It's important for us, but it's also important for the community as well to get back, to get footy back and really enjoy it.
To you, Rhys, now this suggests that you like to pump your teammates up and you're a bit of a motivator, a bit of a inspirational character, or just, am I close to the money here, boys? Someone can jump in. If Rhys is not the bloke to get things rolling verbally at least, is there a bit of substance to that, Rhys?
Yeah, I'd like to think I'm a pretty positive individual. I like to get around my teammates and pump them up when I can.
Okay. I suspect you give the teammates more than you just gave me, Rhys. So I'll ask you another one to try and stretch this out a fraction. Spots in the back line. Don't. Just remember, in the media, we can get you back. Tell us about the back line. It's so strong, so tough to get a gig at the moment. With the bloke to your left and so many good players in form, this is going to be such a competitive outfit to try and break into.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's a really exciting time for the team, yeah, especially our back line. It's great to have Piercy back and Joel Hamling, Hayden Young as well. You know, these three guys are really important to us, and they missed a lot of last season, but you know, really got some young guys coming through, you know, Chappie, Toby Watson, you know, these guys have been really impressive through pre-season and, you know, challenging everyone for spots, and we all make each other better. So, yeah, it's going to be really exciting.
And I guess hub life, although not what you would have wanted last year in any shape or form, but did in some way it drag this young team together. Some clubs didn't have the same feeling of enjoyment, but it felt like yours did.
Yeah, absolutely. I think we went into the hubs with a pretty positive attitude, and we used it as a great opportunity to build a lot of relationships and grow a really strong culture. And, you know, it started there, and especially ever since JL came through, he really preaches that. And, yeah, we've very much taken that into this pre-season, and, you know, it's something that we could forever grow on.
Terrific. And Alex Pearce, of course, great to see him come back last week after at some point we thought, oh, no, not again, but you're in reasonable health. You're such an important part of this defence. You've done so much work. I mean, we see you at training, Joel Hamling, Sean Darcy, guys that have been sidelined. The unseen hours, I guess, which you have to do.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. It is hard at times when the boys are out there training and playing and you're sort of grinding behind the scenes and, in the gym and cross-training and doing other things just to stay fit so that when... And, we do get to make our make our return, that we're in a good physical state. But you did mention a few names, and it is always, I was disappointed to have multiple guys injured when you can work with a few teammates and really drive each other through. You mentioned Joel. Him and I had a similar experience last year with a lot of uncertainty and a lot of setbacks, so it was definitely good to have to sort of bounce off each other physically and mentally to get each other through. So it's, yeah, you do need those. You do need your mates at times to be able to sort of make the most of that
situation.
And
for you, because you've had the issues you've had, is it more as much a mental battle when you go out there just to convince yourself that you're right to go and you'll get through a game or get through a month of footy?
I've always found it all right once I get back out in the field. Things sort of take over. On the weekend when I had a little tweak, there were a few sort of, initially a few demons that came out. But in general, it's pretty good. It's more just that day-to-day grind, being able to refresh and get ready for training each day. But I think the off-season, as we've said, it's condensed, but we got some good opportunity sort of before Christmas to get home. And I spent a month back home in Tassie catching up with friends and family, which I think gave me a great base to be able to come back and sort of give it everything. This pre-season, it's progressed quite nicely. And yeah, I've been able to play a couple of games over the last couple of weeks and hopefully plenty more this year.
Well spoken, Alex. Our last word has to go to the captain. Nat, playing back here potentially, what is it, round two, the Giants off the top of my head, not sure what the capacity will be in terms of numbers, but it does make a difference. You talk about having that extra person, extra leg to get out there and get you across the line in a tight game. The support you get at Optus Stadium is second to none.
Yeah, it sure is. And we're starting to feel the hype externally. I think everyone can see what we're doing here at the club. We've invested heavily in the draft. And our time's coming, so tell everyone that you know when you leave here tonight, don't sleep on the Dockers because we're not far away.
Beautifully spoken. Thank you, Nathan. We know you have to keep... What was that, Reese? Little sledge from Sonny. The leadership group, we know they can't hang around, but I'm sure you've enjoyed just hearing some of their words of wisdom about what's a huge year. It's a long season. Let's hope we see them home and away and everything gets back to normal. Please thank the leadership group, Nathan Fyfe, Andy Brayshaw, David Mundy, Michael Walters, Reece Conker and Alex Pierce. Boys, thank you so much.